The ABCs, why are they so important, especially in this program? What kind of difference can they make?
The difference that the program has made is sort of multi-layered. We oftentimes, children that are first diagnosed with autism and or other related speech and language disorders, they primarily begin their services, even perhaps before they're diagnosed, with speech-language therapy and applied behavior analysis. So the our two professions are very involved in working with children that have autism or autism-like difficulties. Mm-hmm. So most of the time, our professions don't get to mix very often. We work in isolation with each other. So it's been an amazing and incredibly beneficial program for the clients that we've served in the program in the community.
Well, on that note, Tyeashiea, I want to jump right to you as a parent. You know, it seems now more than ever there's more awareness about autism and the spectrum in general. But what is it like for you as a mom to have a program like this right here?
It's amazing. My daughter was born 5 weeks early, and she has a speech delay. And this program has helped her tremendously. She was just saying a few words, and now she's saying more, and she's interacting better. So to have a program where they treat your child like their own children, that was most important for me. So I'm very happy to be a part of what I like to call them, a family.
Yeah, I was gonna ask, from a parental standpoint, what does that mean for you to have a program that's this special?
It's extremely special, and it's extremely important. Like I said, they're like family to me. Mm-hmm. And they see my child and they light up, and she lights up when she sees them. So it's wonderful, and they have really been a blessing to my family.
Sure, Anna, we wanna definitely bring you in to the conversation as well. This coordinated effort though, what does this also bring to the table for all involved, you think?
Well, I think especially because we are in a university, this gives the students who are going to go out and become practitioners in the future and help more children in the future, it gives them a unique opportunity to see what it looks like in other professions, to learn tricks of the trade from other professions. I think the collaboration component and the things that we're able to learn from each other are invaluable for the future of treatment in children, for children in Memphis in the future.
Speaking of the future, that was what it immediately came to my mind. You talked about having folks with different backgrounds all in the same place. Mm-hmm. Is this the way we're going to be looking, or is this a model for potential treatment from now on, whether it's a speech delay or mm-hmm. someone on the autism spectrum or other problems that children may face?
I think that we're seeing, especially for us at the University of Memphis, Dr. Rudd has made lots of gains in different professions collaborating together, and especially in therapeutic services, it adds a whole level of enrichment to Annie and I being able to talk about our two professions that we're both so fond of and be able to learn from each other. And this type of collaboration, I think, not only at the University of Memphis, but with UT and Le Bonheur, can just aid those families mm-hmm. faster mm-hmm. and with higher results.
And that's the key.
And that's the key. Yes. And it's been a very exciting pilot project.